Mamowet PTC200DS. Mamowet is a Dutch company specializing in producing massive lifting equipment. The main challenge for their engineers is to design vehicles that would boost productivity while also ensuring more efficient handling and load placement. Thus, they offered the PTC200DS ring crane, used to move and install big and heavy things in limited locations. The 5,000-ton payload, large boom extension, versatile configuration, reasonably quick mobilization, and compact dimensions are some of its notable qualities. The ring base's size can be adjusted to fit the construction location and the job at hand. Its diameter can be 30 meters, or it can take 6 weeks to prepare this crane for operation. The equipment is 6,125 tons in weight. Although such cranes went into production in 2011, the concept is currently being refined. Engineers, for example, were able to increase their performance in 2018. The crane can now raise monolithic items weighing around 2,000 tons that could previously only be hoisted in parts. Liebherr 16180. Liebherr 16180 is a compact rotary drilling rig that can do a range of jobs. It has substantial advantages. Some of its applications are caliber drilling, continuous flight auger drilling, and twin rotor drilling. The Liebherr 16180 features easy, quick, and low-cost transportation requirements. The rig can be carried using a regular low-frame trailer if the mast and drilling driver are folded. The crane's startup time is short when it arrives at a construction site. The Liebherr 16180 can be configured with a shorter mast if the height of the worksite is restricted. The truck is 53 tons in weight. 34.5 meters is the height caliber drilling depth. A solid, torsionally stable mast is one of the standout features. This means that the unit is designed specifically for heavy construction work. ETF MT240. The first Belaz 75710 was introduced in December 2014, and it was hailed as the world's largest and most load-lifting dump truck. However, in 2018, a new truck was unveiled and beat that record, and it is now being built at full speed. ETF Mining Equipment, a Slovenian business, offered the novelty. The modular architecture of this dump truck makes it stand out. Each module may be moved independently. When combined, they form a train capable of carrying up to 870 tons of cargo. The payload of the Belaz 75710 truck, for example, is 450 tons. Other intriguing aspects of the ETF MT240 include: the car, for example, will be 25% more fuel efficient, while productivity will increase by 12%, according to the manufacturer. The chassis of the MT240 dump truck is four-wheel drive. Each of the five wheel pairs is individually controlled. Because of the manufacturer's design, this massive truck is also powered by multiple engines at the same time, lowering repair and maintenance costs. The engine, gearbox, frame, suspension, and other components may all be swiftly and simply replaced. Liebherr P995. Excavators designed for use at sea are known as pontoon excavators. Liebherr, a German company, makes amphibian excavators like the ones you see on the screen. It has a 380-ton working weight. The backhoe's volume varies between 8 and 18 cubic meters. The maximum depth of excavation is 26 meters. The first excavator of this sort was placed into service in 2004 and has since been a cost-effective and high-performance vehicle capable of handling a wide range of hydraulic engineering tasks. Most Liebherr P995 are installed on pontoons and supports. A diesel engine with a power output of roughly 2,350 horsepower is installed inside the machine. Bertha. The tunnel boring machine you see is the world's largest. Bertha began operations in Seattle in 2013 and was charged with drilling a 2.8-kilometer subterranean tunnel. Drilling began in June 2013 and was scheduled to finish in December 2015. However, there was a 2-year delay due to unforeseen issues. Drilling was finally completed in April 2017. The vehicle is 99 meters long, weighs 61,100 tons, and has a diameter of 17.5 meters. However, the operation idea is pretty simple. There are 260 cutters on the rotor for various tasks. Some of them ruin the ground by breaking into it. Others dig up boulders to move it in. Others scoop up the huge earth and stones, loosen and direct them to the EPB chamber, a screw conveyor that transfers the soil before being taken away by a belt conveyor. The structure has a 25,000 horsepower capacity. Bertha's efficiency is also amazing. It can advance 10 meters per day. It's worth noting that the vehicle's primary function is not land reclamation. Place concrete lining blocks on the tunnel wall simultaneously as the excavation work. They are each 60 centimeters thick. As a result, Bertha does an incredible job. Any other equipment would be more expensive in this situation, and the construction would take considerably longer. Liebherr T8284. The Liebherr T28 dump truck was first produced in 2004. The model was so famous and successful that it was decided to construct a new complete truck based on the same concept. The Liebherr T8284 appeared in this manner. It is the lightest but most powerful member of the heavy-duty mining class. This translates to an empty weight of 600 tons and a payload of up to 300 tons respectively. Despite having a 4,000 horsepower diesel engine, the Liebherr T8284 consumes little gasoline and complies with environmental regulations. According to the manufacturer, the equipment was created to save time on building sites by reducing the number of trucks used. And there we have it! I hope you enjoyed watching these world's largest industrial machines. And if you want to see more of this and continue to be amazed by the never-ending machinery breakthroughs and discoveries, make sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!